Just ask a few questions about how you feel about your upcoming fight on October 22nd. Any messages for the fans and your opponent as well?
Yeah, I just want to say, everyone who's ever, most of the people here probably never saw the first fight, but, this guy here who is, he's been protected by a promotion for the last maybe 5 or 6 years, and then he comes up against someone who's got good solid defense, he crumbles, and, he felt that when he faced me on KSW 39, but, the thing is, he wants to try and play the political card that, you're from Northern Ireland, you're half British, half fucking Irish guy, but I don't give a fuck about that, Look at my two fights when I fought in UFC Dublin. The reception I got from the people of Dublin has been, nothing short of spectacular, so I'm expecting that, and when I come to face this lad again, it's different. When you're a lad from the north, you've got to work a bit harder, you've got to make an impression a bit more than you're a lad from the south, but everyone knows that, But this lad here, who's been protecting his own career, fighting people that's been set up for him to win, but I went into the Lion's Den and fought him a couple of months ago in front of, almost 60,000 people. I pushed the pressure, I stayed on, and this guy, I knew when I walked into the cage, I looked up and saw the big screen, and he was coming in, he set up his little fucking Cinderella dress, and he walked in, he clipped on his high heels, and he run about that cage like a little bitch, a whole fucking fight. That's all he did, you run. Don't talk about defending, mate. Don't even talk about defending. You run the whole fight. That's all he did. All he had, whenever I pressured you, single leg. All he had is a single leg. You know what? People says, Why didn't he push away and step back and bring it back to the feet? You were hanging on to that fucking single leg for your life, mate. And do you know what? You can say what you want, mate. Don't fool the police to me. You did it for fucking the last 5 or 6 years. KSW is promoting you like you're the next big thing, like you're the number one guy at the UFC. I'm respecting on that. You can say number one guy at the UFC, but we need to jump in there. We are higher ranked than fucking most of the guys in the UFC. So I'll give you that. But you fought like a fucking bitch, man. You run in that fucking cage like a little girl, you fucker. You see what's going on? Come on, you see you're going to be smashing fucking hell glasses through your face. So fuck you, you little fucking faggot.
Fuck you. You're fucking dead, son. That belt's mine. You better be the fuck. Come right here, then.
Norman, we wish you all the very best. Yeah, and we thank you for being here tonight as well. Do you know what? Listen, guys, listen. Do you know what? He wants to try and play that bullshit. Listen to me. He wants to try and play the bullshit. You're the guy from Northern Ireland. You're that Ulster guy, the Northern Ireland guy that want to play the bullshit. You come to the North. You're not even Irish, I get that bullshit my whole career. I've done it since ever since the time I joined the Ultimate Fighter. I won it. It's happened my whole career, mate. But look at my two fights in Dublin. 2-0. Look at the fucking respect I got when I fought in Dublin. The whole crowd stood up there and cheered like I was one of their own. There's always going to be fucking be like that, son. You better believe that I'm coming up that belt. I swear to fuck you. I'm coming up that belt. 5 rounds. One more round. Fuck.
Once
again, thanks very much, Norman. We wish you all the best on October 22nd, KSW 40.
Stand up, come on.
Matthias.
Hey.
Any message for your fans? Let's get to talk the upcoming fight.